Yeah, today we will be discussing about the eighth chapter of Bhagavad Gita, which is Sanskrit title is Tharaka Brahma Yoga, and Srila Prabhupada titled this chapter as Attaining the Supreme. Okay. So in the seventh chapter, Krishna speaks mostly about about his material and spiritual energies, and what type of people who take shelter, who take surrender unto him, and about the worship of demigod, and which is good. When we are talking about demigods, we can respect or we can worship demigods as part and parcel of Krishna. Means we should not worship demigods as a supreme person. We should not worship demigod as. We should not worship demigod as somebody who is ultimate authority, who is the ultimate Bhagavan. But when we worship demigods as representatives of Krishna or part and parcel of Krishna, then it will be pleasing to demigods, it will be pleasing to Krishna also. And one nice example that Acharya has given, when a wife is married to a husband, so she respects everybody in the family. She respects mother-in-law, father-in-law, and other relatives of the husband. But she will have special love only to special loving relationship only with the husband. Because she respects everybody in the family because they are related to her husband, and respecting them will please the husband. And there are have loving reciprocations, means, but she will have special love towards the husband. In the same way, we should also respect all the demigods, we have to have that devotion, that bhakti should be towards Krishna. That is the best process of dealing with other deities. Okay. Now, in this chapter, that deals with how until now Krishna spoke about how to perform karma, how to do jnana yoga, how to do ashtanga yoga, means mostly dealing with how to live in this material world in Krishna conscious way. Now in this chapter, Krishna will explain how to leave, means how to exit from this world. What should be our consciousness? So, and how should be our what? What should be our mood while so that we attain the supreme destination or go back to Godhead? So that Krishna will explain in this chapter. So in this chapter. So this chapter summary can be easily remembered with acronym DEAD. D means in the initially Arjuna Krishna clears some doubts which Arjuna puts forth, okay, and that is from verse number 1 to 4. And E means end of life, at the end of life, how should be our consciousness? That is, what should be our consciousness at the end of life? That is, Krishna explains. And from 9 to 22, attaining the Krishna, attaining by you may we can attain like Krishna mentioned different yoga processes, right? Kriya Bhakti Yoga, Ashtanga Yoga, Karma Yoga, and among them. Ashtanga Yoga Mishra Bhakti and Bhakti Yoga. These are using these two, one can attain Krishna. So, what is the best among them? What is the best process of attaining Krishna? Which is the best process that we'll discuss about it? Okay, and finally, we'll discuss how Bhakti is the supreme. So, when it comes to when it comes to our lives, when we are children, when we are kids, we used to ask many questions. especially when you see a kid going with his parents in a street, and kids keep on asking questions, Papa, what is this? What is this? Why, who is this? That inquisitiveness will be there when we are kids. But after we grow up, we lose that inquisitiveness. We know, we think that we know everything, but when we see something even that we don't know or doubt, or even something which is strange also, we don't question about it. That's why when somebody gives us some Bhagavad Gita or invites us to attend any class, you know, or discuss any topic about spirituality, we just listen. Now, some people actually goes to temples, they actually do the formality, take darshan, take offer some fruits and everything, or coconut if it is South India, and then they leave the temple, and they don't know why they are doing this, whom they are offering it. So they do it as a, what do you call, mechanically, and they don't ask questions. They don't ask why am I doing this, what is the purpose that we are doing this. Actually, there is a nice logic and reasoning behind every aspect in spirituality. When we ask the questions, then we'll come to know the actual purpose, no? Like
Prabhu, your voice is breaking.
Is it better now?
Yeah.
Hare Krishna. No, yeah, sometimes it's a connection. So you can join by phone, Prabhu, if it is voice is not clear.
Oh, okay.
You
okay.
can join by phone, okay? So that inquisitiveness we lost after a period of time, okay? So, but if you want to spiritually grow, we have to put ourselves in the, when we are reading Srimad Bhagavad Gita, we have to put ourselves in the position of Arjuna. When we are reading Srimad Bhagavatam, we have to put ourselves in the position of the person who is inquiring, who is putting for the question, and we have to see how it is relevant to us, our lives. And if there are any questions, anything, we should not hesitate to ask, but the question should be put forth in a humble manner in front of gurus, no? And that way they will be pleased to clear the question, doubts. So the doubts in spirituality are like, no, like demons. If you don't kill them, over a period of time, they'll kill us, they will kill our spiritual life. So we should always ask questions, and we should always think how it is relevant to how it is relevant to the context, how it is relevant to our lives, and why this is in Bhagavad Gita. Like that kind of any questions that we may come up. And these questions should be very genuine, and this question should be very, that will be thought provoking, and will be also beneficial for our spiritual growth. So in the same way, in the beginning of the 8th chapter, Arjuna asks different questions to Arjuna. So Arjuna asks what is Brahman, what is Adhyatma, what is Karma, what is Adi Bhuta, and what is Adi Daiva, and what is Adi Yajna, and how is Adi Yajna known in the body, and how to know Krishna, how to know you at the point of death, okay? How to know Krishna at the point of death. So these are the questions that was put forth by Arjuna, okay? And Krishna explains all these questions, until question number, Arjuna, here there are 8 questions, okay, totally. Krishna answers all the 7 questions straight with one sentence, or in one line. But the 8th one, how to know you at the time of death, for that Krishna elaborates entire of this chapter. So we'll see into it, okay? So these are the 8 questions that are put forth by Arjuna in the beginning, okay? And for that, Krishna answers this question, okay? Brahman is like, what is Brahman? Brahman is the indestructible living entity, means the Jiva. indestructible, indestructible Aksharam, the transcendental living entity separate from the material body, that is Brahman. So the means it is not referring to the impersonal Brahman. It is referring to the Brahman within the body. Okay, that is the jiva within the body. Then when it comes to Adhyatma, now we actually discussed, right? Adhyatma, Adhibhautika, Adhidaivika, Kleshas. Now these are three types of miseries are there. Okay, so Adhyatma means is a living entity's nature, which is to serve. Okay, so in Sanskrit, one word will have different meanings based on the context in which it is used. Okay, so here in this context, Adhyatma means, because Arjuna is asking all these questions because he has some spiritual background and he has heard here and there, but he is asking these questions again so that he will get a clear understanding of them. Okay, so Adhyatma is the living entity's nature, which is to serve. Okay, so it is the swabhava, the eternal nature of the or the impressions that accompany the jiva and govern the body. Okay, and what is karma? For that, karma is the reaction that forces the living entity to take material body in this world. Okay, why we are forced to take life after life, one birth after another birth? Because when we do good activity, we have to come back to get the good reactions. When we do bad activities, we have to come back into this material world to bear the results of our bad actions. So that's why good actions, bad actions are not at all good. But what all we can do is we have to do akarma, because we have to do neutral actions. Means we have to do bhakti actions that are related to the service of Krishna. That will not, that doesn't, that those actions will not bind us to this material world. So somebody may ask, why, what is the problem of coming to this material world? That we will see again. Okay, actually if you get any questions, you can actually note down during our conversation and you can ask at the end. That way the flow is not missed. Okay, and what is Adibhuta? Adibhuta is ever changing material nature. It is created, maintained, and then destroyed. So this is Adibhuta refers to Prakriti. Okay, the constantly changing physical world or material body consisting of material elements. This is Adibhuta. And next question is Adidaiva. Adidaiva, who is, what is Adidaiva? Then for that Krishna answers, he who presides over the all demigods and the planets, the Adidaiva, the ultimate universal form of the Lord. Means Adidaiva is Virat Purusha, the gigantic universal form which includes all the demigods and other planets. And the next question is Adi Yajna. Who is Adi Yajna? For that Krishna answers, the Krishna as the super soul is Adi Yajna, the Lord of all sacrifices. Means Krishna is referring, Paramatma said, I am the enjoyer of all sacrifices, the Supreme Lord represented as the super soul. And then the next question, the seventh question is, what is how is Adi Yajna known in the body? Okay, so for that Krishna answers, he is situated within everyone's heart. Ishvara Sarva Bhutanam. Okay, in the heart of every embodied being, that Paramatma is residing in the heart of every embodied being. As the regulator, Krishna inspired performance of sacrifice and other acts. Okay, like for a person to be alive, there are two things. No, the presence, the soul should be present within the body. For the soul should for the soul to be present within the body, the Paramatma should allow that for the soul to live in this body. So as soon as, at the time of death, as soon as the time is up, then Paramatma will says, okay, your time is up. So Paramatma leaves that body. As soon as Paramatma leaves, along with Paramatma, the soul quits that body. So Paramatma is called the soul of soul. That's why. Okay. Without Paramatma, a soul cannot alone cannot reside in the body. Okay. So these are the eight among the eight questions. Seven questions Krishna directly answers in the first four verses. Okay, and then the next two questions is about remembering Krishna at the time of death. Okay, so this is the most important thing. Even like this is the most important thing in our life. Okay, it is said that our life is like a preparation and death is like examination. So everybody has this, you know, time clicking or, you know, a timer on their head. Like every minute passes, we are 1 second or 1 minute, every 1 minute closer to death. So we should be prepared for the death. We should be, you know, we should know what to do at the time of death so that we can attain the better destination in our next life. And also, until now, we were talking about how to be Krishna conscious while we are in this, while we are performing activities in this world. And but now he will be talking about how to quit the body. Okay. So there is a nice conversation in Mahabharata. No, like this, they say that Yaksha Prashnas, right? Like how. When Pandavas were doing Vanavas, then they becomes very thirsty when they are in the forest. Okay, so and Yudhishthir being eldest among them asked the Pandavas to go and see for look for water. So he sends youngest among them, no, Sahadev, to look for them. Sahadev goes and finds water pond, and then when he was about to drink water, one yaksha, he says, you don't drink that water, you will die. For if you want to drink that water, you have to answer my questions, then only you'll be able to, I will give this, I will allow you to drink that water. But this Sahadev, he disregards and he drinks that water and he dies immediately. Means dies means he becomes he dies actually. So and it the same thing repeats with other brothers also, Arjuna, Bhima, no, Nakula and all the brothers, all four brothers comes to the lake and he was very thirsty, and before taking water to his brothers, he thought I should drink water first. Then he drinks, he again yaksha warns, and they doesn't listen, and he drinks water and then he dies. And finally, and Yudhishthir comes looking for them, and same thing happens. When he is about to drink water, this yaksha says, you cannot drink water, and then you have to answer my questions. Then Yudhishthir, being a very knowledgeable person, he says, okay, go ahead and ask your questions. So among those questions, that yaksha, one question was, what is the most astonishing or surprising thing in this world? For that, Yudhishthir answers, ahani ahani bhut. Ahani ahani bhutani gacchanti amalayam. Means every day we see different living entities dying in front of us and going to the abode of Yamraj. But the persons who are staying in this world, who are alive in this world, they think that they are not going to die. They are going to live eternally. And they live as if death is not going to come to them forever. So they don't even consider about the death also. They don't even know that we have to live, someday we'll be living this material world, and we'll be living this body, this entire arrangement, and going out of this material world. So they live as if they think that if somebody dies in front of them, they say, oh, poor fellow, he died today, you know. But for me, I'm not going to die. So the thing is, because we don't know when we are going to die, we may be dying next moment or next day or few months or few years, that's it. But for sure, death is compulsory. Death is must. Whoever taken birth in this world, their death is taken birth along with them. Okay. So when so yaksha appreciate the answer, no? So we should have this understanding that this material life is temporary, and we should be prepared. No, we should have spiritual. We should be always prepared to have right consciousness. No, to be prepared for that. No, for leaving this body at any point of time. So when this Alfred Ford, he is the grandson of Ford. So when he met Srila Prabhupada, only one thing, Srila Prabhupada said, where is your grandfather now? Because by that time he is the grandfather has already passed away. So Ford was a very famous person. He is worldwide famous, but still you don't know where he is about. No, he has nothing. Whatever he has achieved in his lifetime, he didn't get any. We don't know how much he is reaping benefit of that now. So that provoked a thought in his mind, and he took up spirituality, and he took up Krishna consciousness, and he took initiation from Srila Prabhupada, and he was initiated as Ambarish Prabhu. Okay, so this tendency of questioning everything, this tendency of seeing relevance of everything in our life, when we see something, we have to see how it is relevant to us, and we have to make plans accordingly. So regarding Krishna's Arjuna's eighth question, how to know you at the time of death? Krishna says, remembering at the time of death. Okay, at the end of life, what is the best way to know him? Ante kale cha mameva smaran mukta kalevaram yah prayanti samadbhavam yati nastatra samshaya. Krishna says, death is something, and whoever at the time of death, at end of his life, quit his body remembering me alone, at once attain my nature. Of this, there is no doubt. Means the very simple of going back to Godhead. We just have to remember Krishna at the time of death. So, and not only Krishna. Krishna says, "Yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tejatyante kalevaram tam tam evai iti kaunteya sadata bhava bhavita." Whatever state of being one remembers when he quits the body, O son of Kunti, that state he will attain without fail. Means, not only Krishna Loka, but if you remember anything, if you remember about your parents, or if you remember about your children, you are going to come back to be there, to be born to them again. Or if you are going to remember something like, if you are eligible, you will be given the birth again. If you remember Krishna, you go back to Godhead, back to Vaikuntha. But if you remember Swarga, or if you remember anything like that, you'll be promoted there. And there you have to go through your karma, and your papa, punya fal will be accounted. Okay. So that is the thing that is going on. Okay. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a nice example. Okay. This Bharat Maharaj, who ruled the entire kingdom, our India is called. Our India is called Bharata. This entire planet is called Bharata Varsha. India got the name Bharat Desh because of he ruled our country. Means he ruled the Bharata Varsha. Okay. So that person, King Bharata, he actually when he had entire reign over entire planet, and he actually renounced the kingdom and went to forest, and there he was meditating on Krishna and everything was going fine. But one day he got some, developed some attachment to a motherless deer. No, he tried to save the deer, small baby deer, and then he developed some affection towards it. And he was thinking that there is no mother to this small deer. No. And if I don't protect him, nobody, it will be killed by somebody. And he started developing too much attachment to the deer. And it became so much so that one day the deer, he was not able to find the deer. So he searched, and he was searching all through the night. So in the night, he fell off from the cliff and he passed away. But he dead. He was, but during the death, he was still remembering the deer. So due to that he has to take birth as a deer in his next life. So that is, that means whatever we remember at the time of death, that state we attain without fail. These slides are not working. So we should not see death is something, no, something which is taken away from us, something which is taking everything from us. That is true, but death is also, it is a transition to next life. So we are only quitting this body only to have a next body. If we perfectly leave this body, we may be able to go back to Godhead and attain the eternal life. But if not, we may have to take according to as per our karma and as per our consciousness. Okay. So Srila Prabhupada says it is only possible to remember Krishna at the time of death if we keep on remembering Krishna from when we are quite normal and healthy. Okay, so like for suppose if a student, if he has to appear for some exam, it doesn't mean that if the exam is in 1 hour, if he start preparing for that exam from like 1 hour before the exam, he'll definitely is going to fail, right? So for the exam of death, we have to prepare our consciousness every day and every minute or every moment. Okay, we should be always Krishna conscious so that we can be able to remember Krishna at the time of death. So antye narayana smriti, that is the goal, that is the ultimate perfection of human form of life. What is the highest success that one can achieve in the human form of life is remembering Krishna at the time of death. By remembering Krishna, one will attain his original nature and he will go back to Godhead and live there eternally. So therefore Arjuna, Krishna says, you should always think of me in the form of Krishna and at the same time carry out your prescribed duties of fighting, which with your activities dedicated to me and your mind and intelligence fixed on me, you will attain me without doubt. So this is the perfect state of perfect state by which we can be able to remember Krishna at the time of death. Okay, so if we put ourselves in that position of Arjuna, so Krishna is saying to us, no, you should always think of me, you should always remember, think of Krishna in the form of Krishna, and then at the same time try to carry out our prescribed duties, means whatever we are doing, you know, we'll be working, we are a mother, we are a father, you know, or we are a son to our parents, or we are a citizen of some country, or employee of some certain company or something like that, or any position, you are a brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, or sannyasi, brahmana, kshatriya, vaishya, sudra, whatever is our position, we have to carry out our duties for the sake of Krishna, not for our sake. And we should always remember Krishna while performing those activities. And if we are able to do that, that is a perfect stage with all our activities dedicated to Krishna and with our minds and intelligence fixed on Krishna. By somehow or other, we just have to fix our mind and intelligence on Krishna. So that way we can be able to attain Krishna without a doubt. So he who meditates on me as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and his mind constantly engaged in remembering me, undeviated from the path, he, O Partha, is sure to reach me. Okay, that is the purest way. Okay, always meditating on Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So we should always dovetail our all activities. You know, if you are eating, if you are sleeping, if you are, you know, doing any activity, you should always dovetail how this activity can be engaged in Krishna service. There is nothing in this world that cannot be engaged in Krishna service. So we just have to dovetail all the our activities. That way we remember Krishna throughout our life without fail. So Krishna is saying that kind of person is sure to reach him. Okay. So And after attaining what? When we reach Krishna Loka, Krishna is saying, Mam upetya punarjanma dukkhalayam shashvatam napnuvanti mahatmana samsiddhim paramam gatim gataha paramam gataha. After attaining me, the great souls who are yogis in devotion never return to this temporary world which is full of misery because they have attained highest perfection. So Krishna is saying attaining that, like remembering Krishna at the time of death and going back to Godhead is the highest perfection. Means there is no nothing, because for suppose we may have some goals, right? To be a best employee or to be a chief minister or prime minister. No? So whatever are our goals, we have to earn millions of dollars, something like that. After attaining that goal, there will be something higher. There is something higher. If you are a chief minister, a prime minister is higher than chief minister. And if you are a prime minister, prime minister of another country is higher position than our country. But if you are a prime minister of the best country, if you are prime minister of America, if you are president of America, and there will be somebody, someone above you controlling the president. So in this material world, there is and even the gods, demigods, even the Indra, Brahma, even the Lord Shiva, that kind of positions also are temporary in this material world. Okay. What is the highest perfection one can attain is to remember Krishna and go back to Krishna Loka. Means go back to Golok Vrindavan or Vaikuntha. So when one attains that, there is nothing more to achieve for him. Means his life is fully successful. he has achieved the highest perfection. So, and that kind of souls will never fall down into this material world again, which is because this material world is always filled with janma, mrityu, jara, vyadi. So like adhyatmika, and always there are miseries, right? Adhyatmika, adhibhautika, and adhidaivika miseries. So birth, old age, disease, and death. So these are the different kinds of miseries that are there in this material world. So that soul will never come back into this material world again. And this Krishna is speaking about this material world. A Brahma Bhuvana Loka Punar Avritano Arjuna Mamupetyatu Kaunteya Punar Janmana Vidyate. From the highest planet in this material world down to the lowest, all the planets of all the places, all are places of misery wherein repeated birth and death takes place. But one who attains my abode, O son of Kunti, never takes birth again in this material world. Okay. So this is the universal universal material world and spiritual. This is the one universe. So in this universe there is like different lokas, no? This is Bhuloka, earthly planet, and this is Bhuvar Loka, Swarga Loka, Mahar Loka, Jana Loka, Tapa Loka, and Satya Loka. In Satya Loka, Brahmaji lives, okay? And above Brahmaji, Garbhadaksha Vishnu, Garbhadaksha Vishnu is there, okay? So, and there is Durga is the in charge of this entire material world, okay? And there are lower planetary system, Atala, Vitala, Sutala, Talatala, Mahatala, Rasatala, Patala. These are the lower planetary systems. From highest, from Brahma Loka until the Patal Loka, all the places are, there is repeated birth, death, old age, disease, you know, everything is there. So what is the best way one has to go? This is the one universe, and all the universes are situated in Brahma Jyoti. And one crosses Brahma Jyoti, then the realm of spiritual world starts. So here Mount Kailash is there where Sadashiva lives. And from there Vaikuntha planet starts. And finally one goes back to, now this is Ayodhya Dham, this is Dwaraka Dham, and finally Golok Vrindavan. So when one goes to the abode of any of the abode of Krishna, not only, you know, like if one goes to Vaikuntha Lokas also, one goes to spiritual world, he will never fall down into this material world. When one goes to Krishna Loka, that is the best place that one can go, you know, where everyone is full in their swarupa, okay, and fully knowledgeable. So Krishna is saying everything in this material world is full of misery, but one has to aspire for to go out from, get out from this material world. So and next, finally, Krishna discusses how bhakti yoga is best, okay, devotion. Krishna says, O best among Bharatas, I shall now explain to you the different times which passes away from this material world a yogi does or does not come back. Okay, so according to yoga, there are different timings one passes away. Like if Uttarayana, Dakshinayana is there, means when the sun is in the southern hemisphere, if one passes, he'll go to the lower species. If one passes the high, when sun is in the northern hemisphere, he'll go to the higher destinations. So for the yogis, it is very particular because yogis are trying to do all the things by themselves and they are not surrendered to Krishna. That's why when they leave the body, they have to be very particular. You know, like if some scientist is doing some experiments, he has to be very particular about the composition, the amount of chemicals he is putting, so that he will get the desired result. In the same way, a yogi should be very particular about his yogic calculations, when to leave the body and what time to leave the body, what are the grahasthiti, everything matters, okay? Then only he will be able to attain the destination which he desires. But no, like here Krishna is saying, yogis in Padma Purana says, one who has realized the Brahman attains the supreme destination regardless when they depart their body at the time of death. But the devotees, one who has realized Brahman, means one who has realized the one who has become devotees, realized Brahman means one who has become devotees of Supreme Personality of Godhead, their destination, regardless of what time they pass, they go back to Godhead. That is the perfection of the Bhakti Yoga. Those who know the Supreme Brahman attain the Supreme by passing away from this world during the influence of fiery God in the light and at an auspicious moment of day during the fortnight and waxing moon. Means this is the when he's saying like when the sun is in the northern hemisphere, the 6 months when the sun travels in the north. Okay, this that that kind of soul, they can go, they can get a higher destination, Brahma Jyoti. Those who perform the Vedic activities like yajna, donation, food, land, are guided by the demigods of smoke, night, etc., routed to Pitruloka and then to the heavenly realms where they can enjoy rewards of good deeds until their merits have expired. But when one goes to the Swargaloka, they will enjoy in the Swargaloka only until their good merits are there. And when their good merits have expired, then they will fall down again. It's like in a credit card balance. If you are until there is a no, it's not a credit card, it's a debit card. So until there is a balance in your debit card, you will be able to enjoy in the Swargaloka. As soon as your balance is over, you will not be able to survive there. You have to fall down again into this material world to do the karma again and start over all again. Okay. So thus it is very difficult to evolve from position, because only if these different flora are eaten by humans or animals, subsequently emitted by sea. So means this is a very difficult process. No, again we have to fall into this material world. No, like how from the Swargaloka he will pass into the clouds. From the clouds he will be brought down to this earthly planet. And when the clouds give water, through waters the soul enters into the grains, and when father eats the grains, and it will enter into the semen of the father, and from the semen of the father he enters into the womb of the mother. From there he again takes birth again. So it's a very lengthy and it's a painful process. Okay, and the devotees know these two paths of living, the northern living two ways, but they don't care about that. They are never bewildered, even though they know like when to, even though they know or don't know, they don't bother about it. No, and therefore they are always fixed in devotion, because as long as we are fixed in devotion, it is Krishna's responsibility, you know, right? we know about no Markata Nyaya and Marjala Nyaya, right? Markata Nyaya means, Markata means monkey. So if you see the monkey, if monkey baby has to hold the mother monkey very tightly, and mother monkey will be jumping from one branch to one branch to one branch without holding the baby monkey, and it is up to the baby monkey to hold the mother monkey very tightly, then only it will be able to survive. If it by chance releases the grip, it will fall down and die. So that is the Markata Nyaya. And Marjala Nyaya, if you see the cat, Marjala means cat. So cat will hold its baby tightly in its mouth, tight, so that, and also hold it gently so that it doesn't hurt the baby, and it will carry from one place to other place. So cat takes, and the baby kitten is completely surrendered to the mother, and it doesn't do anything. It just stays in the mouth of the mother, and then mother carefully takes from one safer place to another place to another place, one place to another place safely without harming the baby. So that is the difference. This the process of yoga, where the surrender to the, where the devotion to Krishna is not involved. It is up to the yogi that he has to, you know, be perfectly calculated and perfectly do all the yogic things rightly so that he attains the desired destination. But if by mistake, if he does some miscalculation, then he has to, you know, if instead of leaving his body on particular day, he leaves the body in some other day, his experiment, his yogic thing will get failed, and he will end up in some other planet. Instead of going to Sarga, he goes to Naraka. There's a good chance. So, and like the devotees are like Marjala, means they are fully surrendered to Krishna, and it is up to Krishna to take them safely to his abode. So that's why a person who accepts the path of devotional service is not bereft of the result derived from studying the Vedas, performing sacrifices, undergoing austerities, giving charity, pursuing philosophical and fruitless activities. Simply by performing devotional service, he attains all of this. At the end, he reaches the supreme abode. Means, one may do many, many pious things, one may do different studies, but when one is perfect in devotional service, he is not missing anything in his life. He attains all the things that are achieved by any other process, and at the end of his life, he is going back to Godhead. Why so much difference is? The nature of the jivas is jivera swarupa krishnera nitya das. Means by nature, just like it is the nature of the fire to be fiery, it is the nature of the water to be liquidy, it is the nature of the salt to be salty, it is the nature of sugar to be sweet, it is the nature of the soul to be a servant of Krishna. Jivera swarupa krishnera nitya das. So das means not like a slave. Das means it's like a loving relation. Loving, it's like how a child is subservient to a mother or father. How a friend is subservient to his friend. How a lover is subservient to his beloved. Like that, a jiva has loving relationship with the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna. If you just take if one realizes that relationship, then he is perfect. He attains the perfection and he goes back to Godhead without any additional effort. So that's why a person who accepts the path of devotional service is not bereft of any path. Okay. So the conclusion, what is the conclusion? Conclusion is, this bhakti yoga is the best process to attain the best and easiest process and the surest process of attaining the perfection of human form of life. So in order to establish the greatness of this bhakti yoga process, Krishna himself has incarnated as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Lord Chaitanya is called the golden avatar. Okay, so Lord Chaitanya, how can we confirm Lord Chaitanya's divinity? Lord Chaitanya's incarnation is called hidden incarnation. In the recent years, it has become very common practice to sentimentally and whimsically accept anyone as incarnation of God, separating the avatars from avaricious. Avaricious is difficult because anybody can do some miracles and say that I am the supreme personality of Godhead. It's not like that. But for that, we have to have a criteria, right? So Vedic scriptures, actually they give the parameter, okay? So it is called safe parameter, okay? Safe means that incarnation should be referred in the scriptures. The scriptures that should be quoted in the scriptures, because scriptures are given us to by the perfect beings, okay? And astrological and the attributes, okay? Astrological calculation should be perfect, okay? And following the acharyas, the previous teachers, no? And also extraordinary activities, what type of activities he does. So by all these, one should meet all these criteria so that we can accept him as the supreme personality of Godhead. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. That is stated in all these Puranas. Srimad Bhagavatam, Adi Purana, Kurma Purana, Garuda Purana, Narasimha Purana, Padma Purana, Nada Purana, Brahma Purana, Bhavishya Purana, Agni Purana, Matsya Purana, Vayu Purana, Markandeya Purana, Varaha Purana, Vaman Purana, Upa Purana, Ananta Samhita, Mahabharat, Atharva Veda, Sama Veda, Chaitanya Upanishad, Chandogya Upanishad, Svetaswara Upanishad, and Purusha Bodhi Upanishad. Purusha Bodhini Upanishad. Okay. So these are all the prescribed scriptures that actually states that Krishna is going to appear in Kali Yuga in so and so incarnation as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So proofs itself, I have a nice presentation with all these proofs. This proof itself will, if we just show and state the quotations, it will take 1.5 hour to refer all these scriptures. Okay, so just showing the what is the verse that is stated in this Purana and what does that verse says, okay, that itself take 1.5 hour for us to refer. So it is a very lengthy session. So just for now, for the sake of starting, I'm just referring you. I'm just giving this brief introduction of about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Okay, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught this process of Bhakti Yoga, and he advocated it. And he says that, you know, in the age of in this age, this Sankirtan movement means taking the holy name, chanting the Krishna's name, is the best process of attaining the self-realization. In order to establish that, and in order to bring back the misdirected persons into the process of bhakti, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself came. Krishna himself came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and showed how to perform bhakti. He gave Shikshashtakam. He showed through his life example how to take up the process of bhakti, how to please Krishna, like that. Okay. So these are all the verses which states, no? The different verses, important quotations from different scriptures, Chaitanya Charitamrita and all like that. Okay. So this chapter, the conclusion of this chapter is the process of bhakti is ultimate, and if you take the process of bhakti and if you accept Krishna as the supreme personality of Godhead, and easiest way of performing bhakti is to take shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and to follow the instructions of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and to perform bhakti as given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That way we can easily, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is called Mahavadanya, means he is very merciful. He actually, there will be some entrance examinations, right? There is positive marking and negative marking. If you commit some mistakes, they'll give negative mark. And if you commit, if you answer one question rightly, they'll give 4 marks. And if you perform one mistake, they'll cut 2 marks. So this positive marking and negative marking is there in every process in this in this material world, in the existence. But it is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu alone who only consider whatever good we have done and then gives the love of Godhead. And he doesn't and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu are the two magnanimous incarnations of this age of Kali. By by remembering them, by following their path, we can be easily able to transcend this material world. So that's why when we are chanting, we have to know the mantra for this age of Kali is Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. But there are many offenses that we may commit while chanting this mantra. In order to counteract any all the offenses that we commit during our chanting, we just have to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra in the beginning and at the end. Okay, mantra of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nityananda Panchatattva Mantra. That is Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaurava Bhaktarunda. This Panchatattva Mantra will counteract all the offenses that we have committed during our chanting. So that way we'll attain the benefits of chanting the holy name of Krishna and will grow in our process of bhakti. So, and that is the process of easiest process of attaining the perfection. So what is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught, no, bolo Krishna, chant Krishna's name, bhajo Krishna, saru Krishna practically, and karo Krishna shiksha, and follow Krishna's instructions. That is in short what is the Mahaprabhu's instruction how to perform bhakti in this age of Kali. Okay, if you have any questions or comments, you can take now.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Yes, Mata.
So my first question is, does soul has physical energy? Like, does soul has some kind of energy?
So, soul is spiritual, Mataji. So soul is full of energy. Due to presence of soul only, the body gets the energy. No? Otherwise, the body is only made of bone, flesh and blood, right? How can everything in this body does not have life, right? Only soul has life. Due to presence of soul, the body gets the life. No, like see, the what is the difference between a living body and a dead body? Living body have a soul and dead body does not have a soul. No, soul is one by 10,000th tip of a hair. Soul size is very, very small, but still due to the presence of the soul only, even the body is like a big elephant can move, or even bodies like a very, very big bodies like a blue whale can move. As soon as the soul leaves the body is pronounced dead and the body can not even move an inch by itself. Right. So soul has spiritual energy and soul is covered by mind, intelligence and ego. That is subtle body, and above subtle body, the gross body made of five elements is there.
Right. So, and one more,
Yes, Mother.
And one more question. When soul goes to God, doing karma and akarma, and as you said, at the death time, if you remember the Krishna, you will go to Krishna Lok. Mm. So does the karma and akarma still will be there, and then someday you might have to come back to materialistic world that you have done the karma or...
No, as soon as you go to the spiritual world, all your karma, all your good karma, all your bad karma are gone. And like it is like, a child goes out of the father's home. My father is a very rich, father is practically a king. Okay. And this child goes out of home and he wants to start his own business, and he starts the business. So he actually helps somebody, but he sometimes gets bankrupt, and he's not able to pay his bills, and he owe a lot of money to a lot of people, and finally this boy realizes that I cannot survive myself, and he goes to father's home. When he goes to father's home, and all the things, the father will take care of the child and say, what are your problems? Okay, you owe this much money to this fellow, this fellow, this fellow, and father will just give all the money off and then takes care of that child. So in the same way, when we go, how much sinful we may be, when we go to the spiritual world, Krishna will take care of all our sins, and then when we, and we will be remembering all the things that have gone wrong in the material world, no, so that we don't come back to this material world again. So that's why Krishna says, when a soul goes back to the spiritual world, it will not come back into this material world again.
Okay.
Now, because you know, right? Like, as a child, no, sometimes children, they pass stool, and they actually play in the stool only because they don't know how nasty that stool is also, right?
Right.
No, but when you grow up, you have the knowledge. Oh, stool is so abominable. As soon as you see the stool, or you'll maintain distance, right? This material world is like a stool. I mean, it's so abominable. It's filled with a lot of problems, you know. Like, that's why when Krishna descends in this material world, like, when Krishna in his divine form, he does not touch this material world, this earth also. Means, you know, like, it is very abominable thing. It's like, even the devatas, they feel very embarrassed to, you know, to be in to come to this earthly planet, because it is so abominable, because that is the standard of devatas, you know. Like, pigs will be happy in the drainage,
right?
But the humans are not happy, right? Humans cannot go and be happy and comfortable in the drainage, right?
Right.
So in the same way, the devatas are, when we get the spiritual body, this material world is abominable thing, so we'll never come back into this material world again.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Prabhuji.
Anything else? Anybody has any more questions or comments? Okay, I'll end it here. Karantara Srimad Bhagavad Gita Ki Jai, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, Ananda Koti Vaishnava Vrinda Ki Jai. Om Tat Sat. Hare Krishna. See you next week.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.